as all of you know, I mean, here in part of the election campaign for the Progressive Secular Alliance candidates, and particularly for the CPIM, CPI, and for the others who are there in it. And the whole of yesterday that I spent in the parts of Madurai and the Thoothukudi and in those nearby areas, the general, what I get the impression is that it is going to be a very clean sweep for the DMK-led Progressive Secular Alliance. So that is fairly certain from what it happens. And we are sure that we'll win both the two seats that we are contesting, both Coimbatore, with Natarajan here, and Madurai with the vegetation. Both of them that will win. So, but more importantly, what I would like to speak to you today is regarding the Supreme Court judgment on the Rafael case. It is a very significant verdict that the Supreme Court delivered today, where they said that all new documents that have come to light will also be part of the review petition. Now, this is what the government of India, this Modi government, was hoping will not happen. First point is, why was the review necessary? Why was a review petition in the Supreme Court necessary? Because it became clear that the government had concealed facts before the Supreme Court, and they have actually told certain untruths to the Supreme Court. The untruths were that the CAG had already done the auditing for the accounts and submitted a report that was presented to the Parliament, and the Parliament's Estimates Committee discussed that report and approved it. So therefore, there's no need for any judicial scrutiny. Now, this was a complete untruth. There was no CAG report when the case was heard by the Supreme Court. There was no CAG report, therefore it could not have been placed before the Parliament. And the chairman of the Parliament's Estimate Committee has on record said that they have received no CAG report for them to discuss. But the government went and told all these untruths to the Supreme Court. So it was clear that the government wanted to conceal many, many things as far as this deal is concerned. Now, when the new facts came out, new documents came out, and this information was there with many of us in the Parliament, parliamentarians and others, because these are all recorded facts. And when these informations came up, the government took a very, very specious plea, saying that these are stolen documents and therefore cannot be considered by the courts. Today's verdict nails that down and says that all new documents that have emerged after the last verdict that the Supreme Court gave, all new documents, put it on airplane mode. It looks like Anil Ambani Rafael aircraft here. You put it, how is it sounding? So the point is, the Supreme Court today has said no, all new documents that have come to light, they will also be part of the review petition. So the point at issue is, now the truth should come out. Now the documents that have now come to light, part of the investigative journalism that was done by the Hindu, Mr. N. Ram of Hindu, it was done by Mr. Vinod Joseph of the Caravan, it was done by Siddharth Varadarajan and Venu of The Wire. Many have contributed to this, but the Hindu played a major role with what came out yesterday. That is what I think the Supreme Court also had no option but to take that into cognizance. And all these documents showed that there are three things involved. And this is very important in the context of the election campaign. The three things are, one, the question of India's security being undermined. Why do I say this? The deal, original deal, was for 126 Rafael fighter aircraft with two squadrons of 36 coming in ready to fly, and the others being manufactured in collaboration with the Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, a premier public sector organization in defense production. Now, instead of this 126, Modi's renegotiated deal only gives us 36. And Air Force, which was in dire need of squadrons of fighter planes, they have been deprived of 90 fighter planes. And the new deal, stipulation of the timetable when they'll be given, is that for the next nearly till 2021-22, the first of these planes will not be delivered. Now, all this is what has happened in reality, that is, the Air Force capacity was undermined by this renegotiated deal. Today, Prime Minister Modi is all around the country campaigning that national security is the primary concern. They are the only ones who are capable of fighting terrorism. And he also had the temerity to say that if Rafael planes were there, our Air Force would have had a better chance at the Balakot targeting. But why were they not there, Mr. Modi? It's because you renegotiated the deal. And you renegotiated why? That is the second point. You renegotiated because there is a massive degree of corruption involved in this deal, where the Prime Minister's office was directly involved in these negotiations, overriding the negotiations done by the Indian negotiating team, which is the official negotiating team, which is a multi-ministry team set up by senior officers, which is how defense deals are normally negotiated. Their recommendations and their suggestions were overridden by the Prime Minister's office, and parallel negotiations were conducted by the National Security Advisor under direction of the Prime Minister. And what did this mean? Number one, there was an anti-corruption clause that was there in the earlier agreement that was dropped. Number two, that there was a sovereign guarantee that the government of France would give in the earlier deal that was dropped. And third, there's no bank guarantees as well. What is called the escrow account, that you check whether the things have been delivered and then the payment is released. Even that was not done. So all the route for making money, corruption and sleaze, were opened up by the Prime Minister. Number two, what they did was that by replacing HAL with Mr. Anil Ambani's private, but Ambani Defense, whatever that is, I mean, whatever name that they've called it, with that company, which was registered barely less than 2 weeks before the deal was renegotiated. And the HAL was to be the joint producer for the rest of the 90 planes. That would have meant greater technology transfer to India. That would have meant greater employment generation to build these new planes. And now all that was given up in order to allow this crony corporate to gain as a result of this deal. And therefore, in this process, there is a very, very big scam that is involved. Mr. Modi and the finance minister have gone on record saying there is no money trail you can find in the Rafael jet scam, like you found in the Bofors scam. But in today, you cannot find a money trail. There is no need for a money trail, because they have amended the laws for political funding. They brought it smuggled in the finance bill, not as a separate legislation, whereby they introduced these electoral bonds. Now, who buys these bonds, nobody knows. Who gives it to which political party, nobody knows. So all the sleaze money can be routed through the electoral bonds. And thanks to the Election Commission's website, it was discovered that 94.5% of all the electoral bonds that were sold in the first tranche when they were issued, 94.5% of that went into the BJP. So this is the root of the corruption. And the political party can go and encash that money in the bank, all legally done. There's no illegality involved. So this is legalization of political corruption. And that is what they had done. So that is why the Modi government was terrified at the possibility of a joint parliamentary committee probing this. Because all this would come out. How was it that the Indian negotiating team were overridden? How was it that their dissenting notes were overridden by the Prime Minister's office? Normally by the Defence Minister it has to be done, but by the Prime Minister's office. How was the Prime Minister's office directly renegotiating? And the dissent notes are all available, they're all on records, which is what the government says are stolen. One question that I'd like to pose to Mr. Modi is that if you can't ensure the security of secret documents in the Ministry of Defence, how can you ensure security of our country and go around now doing this political propaganda that only they can secure India? So now this is a very clear case, and this is where it has come a day before the electoral process begins. First phase of voting is tomorrow. So before that, this has come, and we hope it will be expedited. And in the interest of the country, and in the interest of our security, in the interest of our Air Force, we will be able to actually ensure that there is no further delay in the requirements for our Air Force. So this is as far as the Rafale is concerned. So we are immediately asking for a speedy hearing and disposal of this case by the Honorable Supreme Court, and we hope that they will be doing this. So that is, what about the Rafale, the new thing that has happened today? Any other question?
No, sir. Now that CPIM and then a few other parties are taking forward the Rafale thing, that is a fight against the corruption. But on the other hand, your party is part of a coalition of which Congress is also a part, where the Congress president is out on bail, former Congress president is out on bail. There has been seizure from people close to Kamal Nath. Even in Kamal Nadu, former minister's house, a few crores were seized. So how do you see this?
What is there to see? I mean, this is all very clearly the question of how CBI is being used as a political tool by the Modi government. What happened to Justice Lohia's murder case? What happened to Shahabuddin's that encounter case? Shahabuddin's encounter case? What's happened to the cases on which they have all been released by the courts? Mr. Amit Shah was also in jail, remember? Unless you forgot. So what do you have to say about that?
No,
will
Rafale hearing be a game changer this election?
Which one?
This Rafale hearing by
a game
changer?
Yes, this actually completely vindicates what we have been saying, that in the name of championing national security is being undermined. In the name of championing the fight against corruption and the most incorruptible government, the highest levels of corruption is being seen through the process of legalizing political corruption. And three, in the name of saying that this is a level playing field for the entire all Indians to develop, to create an aspirational India, a very dynamic growing India, what is happening in reality is naked cronyism, the promotion of their crony friends. Now, who are these people who took all these humongous loans and left the country? How many photographs of Mehul Bhai, that is Mehul Choksi, with the Prime Minister, with that, what Modi is he?
Nirav
Modi. There are so many Modis in India, we are getting confused. Lalit Modi, Nirav Modi, Sunarendra Modi, you know, all of them in that bracket. You know, but they were there. So who are these people who have taken this money, left the country and gone? Now, who is the person who's got privatization of six, your airport authority airports, very, very thriving airports, and suddenly to privatize them on the eve of the election? Who gets that contract? Mr. Adani? Who gets the contract for the first SEZ, information SEZ, just before the elections? Mr. Adani? What is being developed is crony capitalism at the expense of looting our country and empowering our own people.
So while this Rafael issue is blowing up, already that Indian Air Force chief has said that Rafael will be inducted into Indian Air Force by September. On what basis IAF chief would have said?
I don't know, you'll have to ask them. Now everything is coming out very confused. By the original deal, the Rafael should have been inducted by this September. By this deal, where the cost of each Rafael aircraft has gone up by 41%. And because of the manner in which these companies have been given, and that is delaying the delivery of these aircrafts. Now, when is the scheduled delivery? It's very uncertain. Government will give a date, but that is something I am sure cannot be adhered to because there are too many variable partners now involved. So, my point is one, delay, the second one is number. Now, you'll have to buy the other 90 from somewhere. So, for that, you're already spending more for these 36 than what you ever agreed for 126. And now the Modi government will spend more. It was planning to, before the elections came, more to buy that 90. And if those 90 are not from Rafael, if they're from Rafael, the price will be higher.
Yeah.
According to the earlier deal, they could not increase the price. Now they have the right to increase the price. Now if you don't buy it from Rafael, buy it from some other fighter, plane company, then the mismatch will be there. Then there will be tremendous overhead costs for us in terms of maintenance, in terms of engineering, in terms of spare parts. You know, this is a complete mess. So that is why this whole thing has been designed to ensure huge corruption flowing into the party funds of whoever it is, and to promote their own corporate friends.
Sir, do you hope this contract will be cancelled by the Supreme Court coming days?
Well, I hope the contract cannot be cancelled by the Supreme Court, but the strictures the Supreme Court can put will lead to the cancellation of the contract.
That
can be ensured.
Sir, the Maharashtra election campaign rally, Prime Minister Modi has asked the new voters to vote for the warriors, space warriors, for this thing. But how do you see that? The election commission has just given a notice to them. How do you see that?
We complained yesterday. The CPIM sent a very strong complaint to the Election Commission yesterday. And the Election Commission's notice was on the basis of the complaint we had sent. Today's Hindu carries that banner at light. Now, this is a brazen attempt. You know, there are two things involved. One, the Election Commission itself has said recently in a directive that no political party or leader should invoke the armed forces in the election campaign. Now, what the Prime Minister did is in blatant violation of law. Number two, he says, first-time voters, you keep in mind the bravery of our Air Force fighters. So I told him, our first-time voters will maybe vote for an Air Force pilot, but not for you, Mr. Modi. And Modi was only asking about them to vote for the Air Force people who are defending the country. I mean, they are defending the country, whoever be the government. That's why we are proud of them. So, I mean, this is a brazen thing. And today, if you look at it, the Indian Express, Delhi, came out with a very strong editorial on saying, why is the EC being so muted? Why is the Election Commission being so muted and quiet when its own directives are being violated? UP Chief Minister says the Indian Army is Modi's army. Then you say, no, no, that was wrong, a very muted thing saying that, be careful next time. But that is not the, I mean, Election Commission has said that that was wrong, but there is no very strict action that followed. The brazen violations that are taking place to its own code of conduct. And that is why Election Commission, I've said this earlier also, it will be most unfortunate for the country if question marks start being raised on the Election Commission itself. Then our democracy is under severe, severe danger.
In case of your party or your friend gaining a majority, would your party be?
Will you please help me defend my friend?
Front. Are your party gaining a majority? Would your party be agreeable to Mr. Rahul Gandhi's candidature as Prime Minister?
When that happens, I'll answer you definitely.
You
see, your point is report the news, don't speculate. What happens when after this election? There are 7 phases starting from tomorrow. In between, what happens? What happens? Did the tsunami inform you before it came? If something happens. I mean, so you wait till the outcome and then we'll answer the question.
You expect a tsunami in this election?
Yes, it'll be a people tsunami. The election is between Narendra Modi and people of India. நீங்கள் சொல்லுங்க, நாங்கள் எல்லாம் என்னட்டு யுனானிமஸ் ரெசல்யூஷன் ஆல் ஆப்போசிஷன் பார்ட்டிஸ் பாஸ் பண்ணேன். இந்த பீப்புளுக்கு எல்லாருக்கும் சொல்ல கி ஃபைட் அகேன்ஸ்ட் டெரரிசம் இஸ் ஃபைட் பை யுனைடெட் இந்தியா, நாட் பை டிவைடட் இந்தியா. இந்த ஃபைட் அகேன்ஸ்ட் டெரரிசம் தேர் இஸ் நோ ரூலிங் பார்ட்டி, தேர் இஸ் நோ அப்போசிஷன் பார்ட்டி. பட் ஹூ ஸ்டார்டட் திஸ் டிவிஷன் சொல்லுங்க, யார் பண்ணாச்சு இந்த டிவிஷன்? வி கில்ட் ஆல் தி டெரரிஸ்ட் இன் பாலாகோட், ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் யார் சொன்னது? Prime Minister?
Amit Shah.
Next time, he gave a figure, 350. Then Mr. Rajnath Singh says, no, there are 300 cell phones working, they are not working now. So therefore, 300 died. Your cell phone doesn't work, then you are dead, according to the Home Minister. So 300 died. And then one more Cabinet Minister says, 450. One more Cabinet Minister, Mr. Ahluwalia. Surinder Singh Ahluwalia from Darjeeling, he was elected from there, a cabinet minister. He says zero, because Modi government was not interested to kill, it was interested to show that we are powerful. So yaar start panna in the controversy? Yaar solna surgical strike aayirthi, terrorism has ended? Yaar statement adhi? Prime Minister? Adhiki surgical strike appuram Pulwama me edhukachi? Terrorism ended, right? So Pulwama, now Balakot has been hit, terrorism has ended. No more terrorism, solla. Adhikapram, at least 20 of our soldiers have been martyred after Balakot. After Balakot, the bomb blast by terrorists in Jammu. We have controlled the left-wing extremism. The problem of Maoism is over. Yaar solna adhi? Prime Minister, நேற்றுக்கு தண்டவாட யார் அட்டாக் ஆகிடுது? ஹூ வாஸ் கில்டு? பிஜேபி. ஸோ வை டு யூ மேக் சச் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் தென் யூ போஸ் திஸ் க்வெஸ்சன்? வாட் எவ்ரிபடி இன் இண்டியா இஸ் நவ் ஆஸ்கிங், இஃப் யூ சச் எ பிக் ஃபைட்டர் அகேன்ஸ்ட் டெரரிசம், ஆஃப்டர் சர்ஜிக்கல் ஸ்ட்ரைக்ஸ் வை புல்வாமா? ஆஃப்டர் புல்வாமா, ஆஃப்டர் பாலாகோட், வை மோர் பீப்புள் ஆர் டயிங்? வை இன் த லாஸ்ட் 5 இயர்ஸ் கம்பேர்ட் டு த ஏர்லியர் 5 இயர்ஸ் டெரரிஸ்ட் terrorist attacks have increased by nearly 200%. Why have Indian soldiers died in numbers which is more than 300% compared to the earlier 5 years? And today you said all the that they are the only ones anti-Pakistan and all of us are pro-Pakistan. And today Mr. Imran Khan has clarified that as far as Pakistan and he is concerned, they want Narendra Modi to win this election. It is his statement, not mine.
So the Pakistani army chief has recently stated that there might be an surgical strike before 16th of this
Not surgical strike, he said there will be another attack, war attack. And Pakistan has formally complained to the UN Security Council. Which India? India has, of course, refused.
Do you see a threat on Jammu Kashmir accession to India? Because Mehbooba and Farooq Abdullah.
Well, you see, if you make this proclamation, you see, the Jammu Kashmir's accession to India is based on Article 370. That is the basis why Raja Hari Singh signed the, what do you call, joining India, that agreement. Now, if you say that I'll abrogate Article 370, then what are you doing? You're only fueling those elements who want to separate from India. And that is exactly what Mehbooba Mufti and the Abdullahs, they're saying.
Sir, despite the election commission had said that nobody should use the name army for political violence or political gains, still many rallies, political rallies attended by Modi, they are using the word army for political dissent, gain, for
That is very wrong. That's what I was just saying just now. Very wrong, and that is why there are questions now being arisen, arising. Why is the election commission being so soft on violation of its own direction? Yesterday, the Prime Minister himself was asking people to vote for the bravery of our Air Force soldiers. So that's what I was saying. I mean, then yes, if the Prime Minister is asking to vote for the Air Force soldiers, people may vote. But voting for Air Force soldiers is not voting for him or for the ruling party.
Will you launch a complaint in the election commission now?
We have complained. We have complained yesterday, CPIM. And because of the CPIM's complaint, the election commission has issued a notice to the Prime Minister today and asked for the recording of his speech. So let's hope the election comes, because we will be the last persons who would want the authority of the election commission to be undermined. If people start questioning the election commission, that is the end of our democracy, of a free and fair democracy.
Sir, the election commission is placed temporarily ban on releasing PM Modi.
Well, finally it has come today, but by now you have this sort of a caricature of Indian law, whereby the Namo TV, unregistered company, and this thing, but it's already airing and all the cable channels are showing. And the Tata Sky has gone on record saying we get our feed from the BJP's office. Now that channel was showing this film, or I'm told, I don't know, I don't see it. But anyway, glad it has come now, because this is what happened, and you in Tamil Nadu know it better. Whenever MGR was a candidate, was any one of his films being shown? Whenever Madam Jayalalitha was a candidate, was there any single film of Jayalalitha ji shown, displayed in any television channel? Same in Andhra, where I come from, N.T. Ramarao, the others. I mean, this is normal election commission norm. How they took so long to decide on this, which they have been deciding for the last 50 years. That is also, very surprising. But anyway, finally it has come.
Sir, that's what. The last 5 years, the BJP government, Narendra Modi has said that all the farmers will be waived and the GST will be reduced, and they have given a lot of promises to the farmers of India. How do you see that?
Complete betrayal of that promise. Complete, not one of them. 150% cost of production will be the price of the harvest for the farmers, so that they don't get into debt burden. That has not been done. One-time debt waiver for the farmers, so that they don't commit suicides. That has not been done. 10 crore jobs new jobs will be created for the youth. That has not been done. Apart from 15 lakhs of rupees into your account, my account, after finding black money, that has not been done. And all other, so many other promises are there, not one. And this is the first time I am seeing a manifesto of a political party, a ruling party, that issues a new manifesto and does not talk about any promise they made 5 years ago. Normally, a ruling party's manifesto, first part consists of what they promised, what they implemented. That section doesn't, there. Again, the same promises are repeated. That's why, to use the language of BJP President Amit Shah, I said, this is not a manifesto. This is a jumla festo. Jumla means the toys you give to your children in the cradle to make them sleep, make them laugh. You know, so there's nothing to do with reality. There's only to divert the attention of the child, of the baby.
Sir, why not Rahul Gandhi tobriye communist
ennu veego varudha ittin sara solnam sir adu election ku apparam kuda neenga adhe da adukiriya. We already gave a reaction there so many times in the day he filed the nomination. PR Natarajan ku vote panni thirumbi MP as an MP thirumbi Lok Sabha ku anupanum. Today it is absolutely essential that we have a stronger left in parliament so that we can pressurize, like in 2004 period, pressurize the alternative secular government to implement pro-people policies. And that is what he was reminding me just now. And that is why he is important in parliament. He says Rafael is a French company. There is a French company in Coimbatore which has taken over water distribution.
Suyas.
It's taken over water distribution, another French company.
From Gujarat. Two other companies.
Two other French companies in Gujarat, they're also coming. So there's a Modi French connection.
Yes.
But when he goes to parliament, then all these questions will also be raised. So therefore it's important that he must be elected and sent to parliament. Okay?
Yes.
Yes.
Will you be a part of the government if regional parties get a
Yeah, again, as I said, as I was telling our friend, all this speculation, what do you want
just now? Just said 2004 situation, just you repeat. So, will you be a part of the...
You see, there is a 2004 situation, there was a 1096 situation, I mean 1096 situation, where Congress supported from outside a non-Congress Prime Minister and a coalition. 2004, Congress-led coalition of UPA, left supported from outside. So how the electorate will decide on that basis, the new formation that will come out. Okay? Thank you. Thank you.